It all started here along York Avenue and East 30th Street. A neighbor walking up this hill saw a woman run over a man with a car nearly two dozen times.
I mean, I was scared for my life.
Still in fear, Micaela asked us to hide her face. On Saturday, she walked outside to see two men and a woman beating another man with a bat and shovel, pulling his pants down, hitting him in the groin.
And my kids, my daughter, was sitting there watching this, screaming and hollering.
She told the kids to run inside. While on the phone with police, Micaela watched as the woman ran over the man with her car 21 times, killing him.
21 times until he was dead. My head was sitting there thinking, you know, what is she doing? There's kids out here. She's out of her freaking mind. I kept yelling at her to stop.
That's when the woman, who police have not identified, set her sights on Micaela. On the sidewalk, she says the woman chased her down with the car and into the road.
When I did that, she hit me. I went flying and hit the corner of the porch of the White House.
In an attempt to run over her with the car, the woman left tire tracks in this hill and on Micaela's body.
Not that way. Oh, get off.
She's now in excruciating pain, immobile from the knee down.
Oh, it feels like somebody's cut me in half. It's horrible.
At some point during the attack, Micaela says the woman accused the 68-year-old man of trying to rape her.
No, I don't care what crime they've done. You cannot be the judge and the jury, but she didn't have no right to kill a man.
Now, earlier today, we saw detectives speaking with neighbors trying to piece together exactly what happened. Police will continue to investigate. Reagan Porter, Fox 4 News.